So sometimes, as a songwriter, a phrase catches your ear. You're like, oh, cool phrase. Let's write a song about that. Sometimes it's an ethereal thought process. Sometimes it's life in general. Most people, I know that I write mostly out of my life. And that happened several times on this record. One of the times, though, that it happened, I remember it came right out of a conversation that I'd had with my pastor. You see, I had these friends who are, I respected. They were older than me. And on the outside, they seemed to have everything together. But on the inside, their lives started crumbling because of some mistakes that they made. And I remember having conversation with my pastor and getting really frustrated, like, seriously, what's the deal with this? I mean, these people I respected, you know, they had it all together. Why and how in the world could they do what they did? My pastor turned around and looked at me and said, well, Jason, you're not so different from them. He said, all of us are capable of making those kind of mistakes. And I remember feeling really small because in that moment I realized he was telling the truth. Man, we all have choices to make. And this is a sinful and broken world that we live in, and we are people prone to sin. And so that's the thing that really kind of struck me and began this process of writing a song about the sound of hope. And that kind of plays out in my life often, even in parenting. You know, I have two kids of my own, and any parent knows that sometimes you get frustrated with your kids when they won't get in the car fast enough because you're in a hurry to go somewhere, or they're just plain disobedient. I remember one day I got really upset with my son because he wasn't doing something I was asking him to do. And I remember that I kind of turned to him and I was like, Avery, please, son, do what I'm telling you to do. Why won't you do what I need you to do? And I could see that in that moment I had totally crushed his little spirit. I remember realizing, oh no, I've made a mistake here. And so I stopped everything I was doing. I turned around, looked right at him, and I walked up to him. I said, son, I need to tell you I'm sorry. I shouldn't have raised my voice like that. And I won't do it again. I'm so sorry. Remember, I watched this like broken little face light up. A smile came back on. He walked up and gave me a big hug and he said, I forgive you. Daddy, I love you. Isn't that the sound of hope? I mean, that was like the freedom that I desperately needed because I thought I'd made this mistake that was gonna be like ingrained in his consciousness for the rest of his life. But in one moment, he turns around and I knew that he really meant it. He loved me and he forgave me. And isn't that what happens every single day? We have this huge God who loves us, who says over and over to us, in the moment of our sin, in the moment that we need him the most desperately, he says, I love you, you're forgiven. I mean, that's the sound of hope to me. And that's the sound of hope to me over and over again. The fact that no matter where I am, no matter what I've done, no matter how far I get down the hole, God is always there saying, I love you. You're forgiven. And you are mine.